So the goal of today's project is a modular Arduino Rover that can be controlled via Bluetooth. Now, if you're new to this channel, what I try to do is make everything as accessible as possible. If you want to download the 3D files for this, they're there. They're Thingiverse. They're linked below. If you want the code for this, linked below. If there's anything I can do to make these videos more helpful or easy to access this design or make one of your own, just let me know in the comments below. That's my sole purpose, or the sole purpose of this channel, is just to make it as easy as possible to build these projects. Now, stepping back, I want to develop a learning platform, this modular Arduino Rover. That way somebody can step in, build this, but then also use it for future projects. So today's goal is just to build the platform that we'll be using. And then in the future episodes, I'll hopefully be adding just awesome wild things, like maybe a sweet arm to go on it, or a water tank, or a water gun. Who knows? We could put anything on this. An ultrasonic sensor, that way it can drive itself around. But yeah, I'm Professor Boots, but let's go ahead and jump into how we're going to build this. So the key thing to notice here is the 7.4 volt battery. I'm just using a tiny 2S LiPo. As long as your battery source is above 7 volts, you should be just fine. Up next, we got 3D printing. Now let's go ahead and talk about the tracks for this build. They're printed using TPU filament, which, as everyone knows, can be rather temperamental. After all, why did the 3D printer leave its TPU? Because it was too stringy and couldn't commit to one layer.
Yep, that's me. You're probably wondering how I ended up in this situation.
All right, so after that embarrassing moment, let's go ahead and talk about the actual build of this. This is just a little animation I made in SolidWorks of what it's gonna look like. All your 3D printed parts, this is pretty much gonna be all of them together, nothing too fancy. Right here, I'm just using some, you know, classic epoxy to go ahead and glue these two bases together. I did include a file where this piece is just a hole and you can go ahead and print it off all as one, but I personally like to print it in a couple of different pieces. That way, if the power goes out or something goes wrong, you don't lose all your progress. It doesn't look as good, but it's a little safer this way. All right, so these are some adjustable tracks. These are what kind of hold everything together. And I wanted to make sure that you could either lengthen them or shorten them. That way, if your print comes out a little shorter or a little longer, it's just totally adjustable. Now, one thing I want to note here is as I put these track supports on, I go ahead and slide the front bolt in, and then I put in these front geared wheels. Now, before you do this, if you think you're going to be carrying a lot of weight, go ahead and slide in the supports, which are just the two middle bars that you'll see later in the video. Now, as you see here, I got some customization going on. Go ahead and boring out the center hole of this washer just a little bit. Now, this kind of holds on our front geared wheels. That way, they don't slide around too much. As you can see, everybody's tolerances are going to be different. Go ahead and modify as you need to. These two rear motors are a little tricky to put on if your bolts are just a little short like mine were. I'd recommend using just 5mm shorter bolts and you'll be just fine. The two rear geared wheels are super easy. Just go ahead and slide them on and then put two just short screws in, and they'll kind of latch into the hole that's already built into the motor. Putting the tracks on is an easy process. Just make sure that the actual track support is a little closer together. That way you can go ahead and put it on. You'll have some sag, like as you see right here, but that's all adjustable. So you can go ahead and pull it apart and tension them up to your liking, and then tighten those bolts in the middle and you'll be off to the races. Finally, don't forget to tighten the bolts in the front. This just locks everything together. Now this is our electronics tower. I wanted something kind of flashy and standout-ish, so this is where we're going to be mounting all our Arduino Nano parts. This is where our H-bridge, which is what drives the motors, this is where it's going to go. Anything in the future videos that has, you know, a brain, this is where it's going to be mounted. With that, that's the build finished. Let's go ahead and talk about the wiring. This is just a rough wiring diagram to give you an idea. Now I'm using a prototyping breadboard here. This is by no means a requirement, but it just kind of makes everything tidy and a little neater. You could definitely just hook everything into the Arduino Nano if you'd like, but personally for future projects, I kind of wanted a platform that I could build off of. You can see I'm soldering the Arduino pins just over into some external ports. I'm also gonna make a row of 5 volts that comes directly out of the Arduino Nano's 5 volts, as well as a ground row. Now in the bottom corner, I'm just going to go ahead and set up a couple pins. This is where the main battery power is going to come in, and it'll just allow me to power a couple things straight off the battery rather than running it through the 5 volts. Now I like to start by mounting the H-bridge. Just going to go ahead and put a couple screws in each corner. There's already holes in this tower for mounting purposes. And then I'm just using some double-sided sticky tape to mount this Arduino Nano PCB, but you could just hot glue it or whatever you want to do, however you got your setup, totally up to you. Now you can see I attached a power and ground wire, those red and black wires, and this is just going to be directly where my battery hooks in. Once again, not a requirement, but it just kind of makes it look a little nicer and gives me a nice spot to just plug right into. Now all the wiring I'm doing right here, I'd highly recommend just looking at that wiring diagram. It'll explain it way better than I can just by talking. And with that, your build comes to a close. Just don't forget to upload your code and you will be good to go. Real quick, I just want to go ahead and show the Appdabble, D-A-B-B-L-E. This is what we're going to be using to control little Timmy in our future projects. And this just hooks right up to that Bluetooth module we installed. Alrighty folks, at this point you might have yourself your own little Timmy. Go ahead and drop a comment down below how the build went, and make sure to check back in a couple weeks or so for additions that we'll surely be adding to our sweet little Timmy. See you next time.